हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ कल्पेश कापड़िया, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन सिविल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट एट डॉक्टर सुभाष टेक्निकल कैंपस। वेलकम टू ऑल टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो सेशन वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट हिस्टोरिकल बैकग्राउंड ऑफ कंक्रीट, हिस्ट्री ऑफ मॉडर्न सीमेंट, मैन्युफैक्चरिंग प्रोसेस ऑफ सीमेंट, journals available in the field of concrete technology, and last one is authorities in the field of concrete technology. So let's start with the historical background of concrete. The word concrete comes from the Latin word concretus, which means compact. Now a days concrete is most common and necessary things in our life. It's a composite material composed of coarse aggregate bounded together with a fluid cements which hardens over time. So we all know concrete is composite material and is composed with water, cement, fine aggregate, coarse aggregate and admixtures. So it's an artificial stone made of sand, stone, water and cement. The history of cementing material is as old as the history of engineering construction. So kind of cementing materials were used by Egyptians, Romans, Indians in their ancient constructions. It is believed that the early Egyptians mostly used cementing materials, and it's obtained by burning of gypsum. Then the Greeks and the Romans used calcined limestones, and later learned to add to lime and water, sand and crushed stone or brick and broken tiles. This was the first concrete in history. The Roman builders used volcanic stuff found near Pozzuoli village near Mount Vesuvius in Italy. Some of the Roman structure in which masonry was bounded by mortar, such as the Colosseum in Rome and the Ponto Guard near Nimes, have survived to this day, with the cementitious material still hard and firm. It learned that the Romans added blood and milk to their mortar and concrete to achieve better workability. Also, hemoglobin is a powerful air entering agent and plasticizer, which perhaps is yet another reason for the durabilities of Roman structures. So probably they did not know about durability aspect, but use them as a workability agents. Then in India, powdered bricks named Surkhi has been used in mortar. Then when we come to more recent times, the most important advance in the knowledge of cements, the foreigner to the discoveries and manufacturing of all modern cement is undoubtedly the investigation carried out by John Simpsons. Then history of modern cement. In the history of modern cement, first one is John Simpsons was called upon to rebuild the Eddystone Lighthouse in 1756, he made extensive inquiries into the state of art existing in those days and also conducted experiments to view to find out the materials to withstand the severe action of sea water. He found that the best mortar was produced when pozzolana was mixed with limestone containing a high proportion of clay matter. He was the first to understand the chemical properties of limestone. Second is in 1796, hydraulic cement was produced by calcining nodules of argillaceous limestones. In about 1800, the product thus obtained was called Roman cement. Then third, L.J. Wickett carried out detailed investigation and prepared an artificial hydraulic lime by calcining an intimate mixture of limestone and clay. Then in 1811, James Forrest patented a cement and established a factory in London districts. Then in 1824, Joseph Espadin, a Leeds builder, took the patent of Portland cement. The fancy name of Portland was given owing to the resemblance of this hardened cement to the natural stone occurring at Portland in England. Hard limestone and finely divided clay were used as a raw materials. In 1845, Isaac Charles Johnson burnt a mixture of clay and chalk till the clinkering stage to make better cement. He also established cement factories in 1851. The German standard specification for Portland cement was drawn in 1877. The British standard specification was first drawn in 1904. The ASTM specification was first drawn in 1904. In India, the South India Industrial Limited first manufactured Portland cement near Madras, in Chennai, in 1904. In 1912, the Indian Cement Company Limited was established at Porbandar, Gujarat, and by 1914, this company was able to deliver about 1,000 tons of Portland cement. Prior to the manufacture of Portland cement in India, it was imported from UK, a three-story structure built at Byculia, Bombay, is one of the oldest RCC structure built using Portland cement in India. The Cement Corporation of India, a government-owned company, is set up with aim of surveying, prospecting and providing limestone deposits in the country and establishing cement manufacturing capacity. So now, in India, there are many cement manufacturing companies, and apart that, the leading cement manufacturing companies in India. So first is Associated Cement Company, SCC, then Ambuja Cement, then Birla Group of Company, then Binani Cement, then Athi Cement, then Grajim Cement Company, then Sanghi Cement, देन बिनानी सीमेंट कंपनी, हाथी सीमेंट कंपनी, ग्राजिम सीमेंट कंपनी, सांघी सीमेंट कंपनी, श्री दिग्विजय सीमेंट कंपनी लिमिटेड, अल्ट्राटेक सीमेंट कंपनी, हाईबॉन्ड सीमेंट कंपनी. सो दिस ऑल कंपनीज आर लीडिंग इन मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ सीमेंट इन इंडिया. नाउ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इज मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ सीमेंट. द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ सीमेंट इन्वॉल्व्स वेरियस रॉ मटेरियल्स एंड प्रोसेसेस. सो देर आर टू मेन रॉ मटेरियल्स फॉर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ सीमेंट. फर्स्ट वन इज कैल्सरियस मटेरियल, सेकेंड वन इज आर्जिलेसियस मटेरियल. सो ईच प्रोसेस इज एक्सप्लेन्ड केमिकल रिएक्शंस फॉर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ पोर्टलैंड सीमेंट. सीमेंट इज अ ग्रीनिश ग्रे कलर्ड पाउडर मेड ऑफ कैल्साइन मिक्सचर ऑफ क्ले एंड लाइमस्टोन. व्हेन मिक्स्ड विथ वाटर बिकम्स ए हार्ड एंड स्ट्रॉन्ग बिल्डिंग मटेरियल. सो द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग प्रोसीजर्स ऑफ पोर्टलैंड सीमेंट इज डिस्क्राइब बिलो. सो देर आर फोर स्टेजेस ऑफ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ सीमेंट. फर्स्ट वन इज मिक्सिंग ऑफ रॉ मटेरियल, सेकंड वन इज बर्निंग, थर्ड वन इज ग्राइंडिंग एंड द लास्ट इज स्टोरेज एंड पैकेजिंग. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट स्टेज, मिक्सिंग ऑफ रॉ मटेरियल. The major raw materials used in the manufacturing of cement are calcium, silicon, iron and aluminium. So these minerals are used in different form as per the availability of the material. So there are two types of raw material. First one is calcareous material. In calcareous material, the main ingredients is calcium. So calcium is from limestone, marls, calcite, aragonite, shale, sea shale or cement kiln dust. And the argillaceous material is from, and then its ingredients from silicons, aluminiums and irons. So silicons from clay, marl, sand, shale, fly ash, risal ash or slag. The aluminium from clay, shale, fly ash, aluminium or refuse. The iron from clay, iron ore, mill scale, shale or blast furnace slag. So these are the two main raw material for manufacturing of cement. So now the mixing procedure of the manufacturing of cement is done in two methods. First one is dry process and second one is wet process. So let's start with the dry process of manufacturing of cement. So now we are directly go on to the figure for better understanding. So first process is dry process. In dry process, the both calcareous and argillaceous raw materials are finely crushed into the gyratory crushers to get 2 to 5 centimeter size pieces separately. Then crushed materials are again grinded to get fine particles into ball or tube mill, and then the crushed material is stored into the bins or silos. Each finely grinded material is stored in hopper after screening. Now these two powdered minerals are mixed in required proportion to get dry raw mix, which is then stored in silos and kept ready to the and kept ready to be sent into rotary kiln. Before rotary kiln, this material is stored into the silos. Now the raw materials are mixed in specific proportion so that the average composition of final product is maintained properly. Then second mixing method is wet process. So better understanding, we are directly go on to the figure. In wet process, the raw materials are firstly crushed and made into powdered form and stored in silos. Then the clay is then washed into washing mill to remove adhering organic matter found in clay. So second step is washing mill. In washing mill, the calcareous material is washed, calcareous and argillaceous both material are washed into washing mill for removing the matters. The powdered limestone and water washed clay are sent to flow in the channel and transfer to grinding mills, where they are completely mixed and the paste is formed and is known as slurry. Then after, grinding process can be done in ball or tube mill or even both. Then the slurry is led into collecting basin where composition can be adjusted. So in this figure, there are mixing and pulverizing option, so where the composition can be adjusted, the slurry composition can be adjusted. Then slurry contain around 38% to 40% water that is stored in storage tank and kept ready for the rotary kiln. So this is the first stage, and now second stage is burning of raw materials. The burning process is carried out in the rotary kiln while the raw material are rotated at 1 to 2 rpm at its longitudinal axis. The rotary kiln is made up of steel tubes having the diameter of 2.5 to 3 meter and the length differ from 90 to 150 meter. And the inner side of the kiln is lined with refractory beaks. The kiln is supported to the columns of masonry or concrete and rested on roller bearing is slightly inclined position at the gradient of 1 in 50 to 1 in 30. The raw mix of dry process of corrected slurry of wet process is injected into the kiln from the upper end. Then the kiln is heated with the help of powdered coal or oil or what gas is from the lower end of kiln so that the long hot flames is produced. Then as the kiln position is inclined and it rotates slowly, the material charge from upper end moves toward lower end at the speed of 15 meter per hour. The upper part, water or moisture in the material is evaporated at 400 degrees Celsius temperature. So this process is known as drying zone. So in the kiln, first zone is drying zone, where the temperature of drying zone is 400 degrees Celsius, where the vapor or moisture in material is evaporated. The central part of kiln is calcination zone. The temperature is around 1000 degrees Celsius, where decomposition of limestone takes place. In decomposition, the remaining material is in the form of small lumps known as nodules after the CO2 is released. The lower part, like clinkering zone, have temperature in between 1500 to 1700 degrees Celsius, where lime and clay are reacts to yielding calcium aluminates and calcium silicate. These aluminates and silicates of calcium fused together to form small and hard stones are known as clinker. And this clinker size is varies from 5 to 10 mm. The clinker coming from the burning zone are very hot. To bring down the temperature of clinker, air is admitted in counter current, the current direction at the base of rotary kiln. So the cooled clinker are collected in small trolleys. And third stage is grinding of clinker, and fourth one is storage and packaging. So let's see the grinding of clinker. The cooled clinker are received from the cooling pans and sent into mills. The clinkers are grinded finely into powder in ball mill or tube mill. And this powdered gypsum is added in this grinded clinker with add powdered gypsum is added around 2 to 3% as retarding agent during final grinding. So flash set is not done in mortar or concrete while we are using cement with water. The final obtained product is cement that does not settle quickly when comes into contact with water. So for that we added a gypsum is about 2 to 3%. After the initial setting time of cement, the cement becomes stiff and the gypsum retards the dissolution of tricalcium aluminates by forming tricalcium sulfoaluminate, which is insoluble and prevents to early further reaction of setting and hardening. Then the grinded cement is stored in silos, from which it is marketed either in container load or 50 kilogram bags. Let's see the figure of whole process of manufacturing of cement. So see in the figure, the first process is, first of all, raw materials are excavated by using excavator from quarry. Then this raw material is transported by truck to the manufacturing plant. Then the limestone is roughly crushed, and this roughly crushed material is finally crushed in secondary crusher and stored in silos. So there are two silos in this figure. First one is for clay, and second silos is for sand. And second process is then both material are grinding into the grinding mills, and then go to the preheater tower, when the material is heated by hot air, and then goes to the kiln. The kiln is here in 125 to 113 position. So first one is first in kiln. First in kiln, and when the preheater tower, when the material is heated by hot air, goes to the kiln. Sorry, the clinker is produced, then hot clinker go to the cooler. After that, cool clinker are collected in trolley, and then clinker are goes into the final grinding with mixing of gypsum, and then finally cement is packed in bag and stored in storage. And then journal available in the field of concrete technology. So there are many journals. First one is Indian Concrete Journal, publisher is Indian Concrete Association, and second is Indian Architect and Builder, then third one is Journal of Institutions of Engineers, then New Building Materials and Construction Review, Civil Engineering and Construction Review, then Concrete International Journal is published by American Concrete Institute in USA, and then Architectural Concrete is also published in American Concrete Institute in USA, then Concrete Research is also published in American Concrete Institute in USA, then Indian Standard Publications is published by Indian Standard Institute in New Delhi, then the authorities in the field of concrete technology. Indian Standard Institute ISI, New Delhi, it publishes standard related to concrete. It has developed concrete mixed design process. Then Indian Road Congress, IRC, New Delhi, research on materials for road construction, construction method and other developments. And Concrete Association of India, Mumbai, it publishes handbooks, guides and journals on the research work on concrete carried out nationally as well as internationally. Structural Engineer Research Institute, Roorkee, to research on concrete technology and structural engineering. The Cement Research Institute of India, New Delhi, research on cement and its properties, used and publications. Then Cement Corporation of India, New Delhi, then Roar Research Laboratory, RRL, in London, in United Kingdom, then American Concrete Institute, SEI, USA, research and development on concrete and publication of papers. So these are the list of references: Concrete Technology MSCT, Concrete Technology Atul Prakashan, and the contractor website, then now we are concluding our session. In this session, you have any further questions or any doubt, so that put into the comment box. Thank you very much.